My next lecture is about the cell lysis techniques which can be used during the lysis of cells while purifying the intracellular proteins. Cell lysis methods may include physicomechanical methods and the chemical methods. Physicomechanical methods include homogenizer French press method, freeze-thaw cycle, sonication, thermolysis, decompression, mortar and pestle, and bead mill method. While the chemical methods may include the use of enzymes and detergents. In homogenizer French press method, the equipment used is shown in this figure. As you can see, there is a large cylindrical body which contains our sample, and there is a piston which is driven into this large cylinder by a hydraulic pump, as a result of which this sample is exposed to high pressure. This highly pressurized sample is squeezed through an outlet tube, which is quite narrow. As the fluid passes through this tube, it experiences shear stress, and as a result of this stress, there is a decompression which leads to disruption of the cell. Next method is freeze-thaw cycle. During freeze-thaw cycle, cell suspension is frozen in dry ice, ethanol bath or freezer, as a result of which ice crystals are formed. In next step, thawing is performed. Thawing is the melting of the frozen material at room temperature or 37 degrees centigrade. As a result of thawing, cell expansion occurs, which leads to cell disruption. Third process is sonication or sonoporation, which involves the use of high frequency sound waves, the frequency of which is mostly more than 20 kilohertz. As you can see, there is an apparatus which is known as sonicator. Here you can adjust the temperature as well as the time for sonication. Now the sample in the form of cell suspension is placed in this empty space, which is filled with water. The tube containing our required sample solution is then exposed to high frequency sound waves, which break the intermolecular forces, as a result of which cavitation occurs, which is the disruption of cell membranes leading to cell lysis. The walls of the sonicator, due to production of these high frequency sound waves, continuously produce heat, which may cause the temperature of the water to raise. And it may lead to denaturation of the proteins. As we know that proteins are stable only at low temperatures. So in order to protect the proteins from denaturation, we are supposed to keep the temperature of the water low. For that purpose, we can add ice periodically to the water. Next method is thermolysis, which is the lysis on exposure to high temperature. But constant high temperature is never preferred for cell lysis because it may lead to protein denaturation. Therefore, short high temperature shocks or longer exposure at low temperature is preferred. In case of gram-negative bacteria, in order to release periplasmic proteins, the temperature of 50 degrees centigrade is preferred, while in case of E. coli, the 90 degrees centigrade temperature is preferred in order to release the cytoplasmic proteins. Next method is decompression, in which cell suspension is mixed with pressurized gas. The gas enters the cell, which leads to cell expansion. Release of pressure causes decompression, which leads to cell lysis. Next method is mortar and pestle. Here you can see a bowl-shaped part of this equipment, which is known as mortar, while the stick-shaped part is known as pestle. In the mortar, the sample, which is to be lysed, is placed. And this method is mostly preferred in case of plant and animal cell, where the cell walls are quite rigid. While grinding with the pestle, the sample is exposed to liquid nitrogen, as a result of which cell becomes frozen and brittle and the lysis becomes easy. And then proteins are extracted by adding the solvent in mortar. Next method is bead mill method. A pin-type bead mill is shown in this diagram. Here there is an agitator. In this part of this bead mill, there is an agitator, and this agitator contains the beads. When this agitator moves, the beads also moves. In this part of the bead mill, the cell suspension is exposed to these moving beads, which collide with the cells in suspension form and walls of the cylinder, also exert kinetic energy to the cells, which leads to breakage of the cell walls and organelles. The concept of bead mill method can be explained through this video. This is a bead mill apparatus. Here you can see the agitator, which is agitating as a result of beads, as a result of which these yellow beads are moving. And here in this part, the cell suspension is exposed to these moving beads, which cause the leases. Next are chemical methods for cell leases, which may involve the use of enzymes. Mostly the enzyme used for the leases of cell wall of gram-positive bacteria is lysozyme, which causes hydrolysis of beta-1 for glycosidic bond in peptidoglycan. The second enzyme which is used for the leases of cell wall of fungus and yeast is the zymolase, which breaks the beta-1,3 glycan bond. The next chemical which can be used in this method are the detergents. The detergents can be classified into three types. One is anionic detergent with negative charge, which the most common example is sodium dodecyl sulfate. This anionic detergent breaks the protein-protein interaction and causes cell leases. Second type is cationic detergents, which are positively charged, and it includes cetyl trimethyl ammonium bromide, which is also known as CTEP. It denatures proteins and solubilizes membrane lipids. Third type is non-ionic detergents, which includes Triton X100, which solubilizes the membrane proteins and causes cell leases. So these are the various cell leases methods which are employed during the extraction of protein from the cells, extraction of intracellular proteins. As a result of these techniques, we get a crude extract of proteins, which are further purified and processed, this processing will be discussed in my next lecture. Thank you.